Which is why I'm curious that neither team's supports are putting a bigger focus on blocking out jungle camps. Axe went for an Iron Town, and I would think that Dazzle probably, especially in 7.02 with some, oh, Fero mid.
Kickback, medium raise, long raise. He does have the fairy fire though. Sunstrike at the turnaround onto Noya. Noya's going to be dropped pretty low, but it's going to be Baby Knight with an uphill hit to secure the first blood against Fero. Crush comes in from Yapzor. They might just be able to, oh no, Noya. He rolled slightly right. Ferev wasn't able to get the timber chain onto him. Still might be able to catch him though. He does not have whirling. Yeah, that was a weird rotation. Roll in. They still know that that Lifestealer's around, so I'm a little bit surprised Noya attempted that one. The crush is going to be missed though, and Yapzor is going to be taken out by the long range raise of Baby Knight. That was awkward on both sides. Noya rolled in, knowing Lifestealer and Slardar were still around the neighborhood, and then Slardar ends up missing. It's cold. Bears seem to be off as a whole. You know, Tsunami, I swear, they're actually really good at execution. We've seen really good things. Fada comes back in a mid lane. Sunstrike's gonna miss, but maybe the kick, not gonna be in time. They do have Yapzor trying to chase down Noya still, but the sleep comes out from Ryze. They finally get a successful kill on the board for Bears. That's like the fourth attempt by them. And a large part of it was that kind of weird rotation. You don't expect Roche a Lifestealer. Yeah, they got him. You don't expect a Lifestealer to be rotating in the mid lane like that, but Fada's just, you know, gonna be jungling half the time. So Dazzle early level 6. He can finally have the weave out. Ooh, top lane. Looks like they might be able to finish off Ace here with the pure damage finally coming in. They have the Chakram ready to go in just a second. Another Timber Chain. Nicely placed. Ferev does end up going to the tower and will end up dying for that kill, but well worth it. We said Ferev is the one who's going to be behind it.
But now they get the jump on the Razor, forces them to go back now. Meanwhile, in the bot lane, though, Hestajo's kind of hungry.
The kick leads into Hestajo, getting the positioning. He actually gets a little bit farther to the right to make sure he grabs the range creep and the seized creep to get these necessary spins to finish off the Axe. A very nicely executed combination between on Bane that you're going to try and go for a Lifestealer kill. It's kind of one of those dead lanes, right? You don't want to risk it too badly, so you'd much rather get the kill onto Fero. The roll in is going to miss as Fero kind of comes forward, but you do manage to hit the stun into the call, and that'll be a pretty easy kill. 3-5, Cloud9 picking up the pace here with that early smoke. Bears just going to be a little bit too late with the smoke of their own.
A lot of rotations mid. No one is in the bot lane right now. This Lifestealer is still looking for kills. He's roaming, and this is the one position. Now they might find Ace, and that would be nice.
They are going to be able to slow him down, and that'll lead into Ferev getting damage necessary. It looks like Fada will be the one to pick up the kill. And this is kind of, we kind of expected this in some ways, right, from Bears, because we said they didn't have that really good, like, controlling tempoer in mid lane from the because of the Invoker pick. So they needed the Lifestealer and the Timber Saw to make up some of the ground. Fero's going to be gone on again here. He does have Dazzle behind him. So Adam is going to attempt to Shallow Grave here, but actually gets silenced up. Distance is there, unable to get off the Shallow Grave in time. Very well played by Noya. This Earth Spear is just so damn destructive. Top lane, Hestajo is going to be up next. Corrosive Haze looks like unable to get any cooling blade off. Everyone too high HP, but it looks like Ferev man.
Razors typically go for now. We unpause.
All right, we'll see
damage.
If Ryze can get the sleep onto any of these heroes, looks like he's not going to be able to catch the Timber Saw. Yep, so we're kind of sacrificing his life to be able to make sure that core does get out.
Man, they actually placed a cliff ward to get that, and they only got
making it so they can't take the tower. They are going to have to back off, and this is just time well spent for Bears. They finished off the armlet and gotten a decent chunk of change onto Fada as he starts working towards that Desolator. And Fero's been kind of half jungling. With little issues there, trying to pick up that
Adam
minus.
Oh no, Adam.
Adam is in deep. That's okay. Adam, he gained information. Fada immediately TP's the other side of the map. He's like, see ya, thanks for the heads up, Adam.
Fortunately, the scan is down, so they don't really know the angle of approach. And the scan for Dire is up, and they know exactly where Radiant is.
They see Adam. Now, Ferev is sitting out in the trees here, so they are going to quickly get an Adam kill, and that's great and everything, but Hestajo is going to drop for it. Nicely baited out by Bears. After all, like, Dazzle is a hero that normally you don't want to bait out because he's your saving hero with Shallow Grave, but against an Axe, you can afford to lose that hero day and night. Like, who cares?
Oh, Noya, bot lane, getting sliced up.
Oh, the Sunstrike! It's not enough, but he does have the chase with the Chakram. Ferev will manage to pick up that kill. Now, he has Silence up, so he's not going to make an immediate retreat. Baby
TP.
Knight is here. He does have...
Ferev got two Bloodstone charges out of that, so they're just
stun
fine
on
with
that. Stun Joe before he can manage to get the Blink call. Now, the kick comes out. Noya is going to miss on the Adam. Looks like Adam is going to be the one that falls again. Adam's just like, this is my life. I accept it. I will always be a sacrificial lamb.
Fada and Yapzur just hold hands as they go down and explore the enemy jungle, and they might find... Oh, there we go.
I was about to say, it made sense before, but now they've got the Blink Dagger. They see Hester Joe walking over, who's the big counter to the Infest combination anyway. So they managed to jump him first, quickly get that kill, and start going... In a little bit of timing here, and I don't think they should be giving up any towers if possible.
I'm surprised that Barriss is backing off. I mean, never mind.
They go back in. Baby Knight's going to be caught by the Sunstrike. They just didn't have the backup. Ryze is way too late to be able to get a defensive sleep out there. Fada is going to be controlled up by the ultimate there. Fada is going to be run down. They need the Axe, though, to be able to get the Shell Grave. They managed to sleep him, stall him up. Fada's not going to be able to TP out. They will manage to get that double kill. But it seemed like Cloud9, honestly, their timings were just a bit off. If Baby Knight wanted to, for a Razor, like I don't feel like he's impactful enough, in part because of the Boots of Travel pickup. Maybe the next team fight will change my mind about that, but it does seem like they just don't have the overwhelming power like they should right now. They are going to be able to catch Yapzur, Blink in call, but Ferev responds with a good combination onto Hester Joe, missing the Culling Blade, so they're not going to have that extra movement speed. Ferev actually gets off a three-man crush and maybe finish off Hester Joe. Hester Joe does get a defensive sleep out there, and Firo teeping away. Invis is good. Noya couldn't get the kick out. Adam... Once again, he will be dying here, but the two supports go down on the side of Barriss. Cloud9, we're hoping to be able to get more, hoping to be able to get Cork to suffocate the farm of at least the Timbersaw and the Lifestealer more and have more of a net worth advantage over those heroes.
As a Razor, sometimes you need to think, like, is my job to build... Oh, man.
Two man. Oh, stun. Nice. Nightmare. Sleep save. That's a beautiful one. They managed to get the Fiend's Grip onto Fada as well. Somebody needs to be able to stop this backline. Fada's already down to half health. Adam gets nuked down. Now Fada may end up going down as well. Hester Joe, get that Culling Blade. Can't get it, but the damage over time will suffice. Noya, kick out. Barely missing Ferev as it trims his ass hairs there. Ferev does manage to get back to the tier two. What an initiation there from Barriss, resoundingly defeated by C9. Now another initiation, another two-man call. This time the combination is on point. Ferev, of all things, gives a right-click to Razor to finish him off. Now tries to go for another one, misses the tree there. Looks like he still managed to catch Hester Joe. They'll be able to get that kill, turn it into Noya as well. Noya going to try and kick away and roll, but they do have the Yule Scepter, which sets up the Sunstrike combination. They'll take four down of Cloud9. It went from initiation, beautiful one, from Barriss going...
Talents, give it some more damage whenever single target.
Initiation, Barriss.
Illusion.
Get an illusion, and... Oh, God, Ferev actually completes that TP. They're still going to fight this one out. Ferev's right on top of Baby Knight, though. Baby Knight blows him up with a big-time ultimate. Now, Fada's going to lose all his damage, and he has nowhere to run to. He has an Aegis, yes, but he's going to be surrounded on all sides. He has a Rage up as he comes back, so maybe, just maybe, he can get an escape out of this one, but there's a call from Hester Joe. Fada looks like he's going to be blown up before he can infest anything, so he's donezo. Wow, that was huge. Cloud9, Baby Knight getting one hell of a Requiem of Souls right on top of Ferev, who is one of the harder heroes to eat through.
And one of the best heroes to get that amount of magic damage on, especially in the beginning of the fight. Just eliminate. Oh, wow. Hester Joe getting a kill on Yapzur.
Yeah.
If they can remove the Timbersaw.
You both are just taking a regular old 5 versus 5. Initiation on a Baby Knight here. Ferev's going to bring him down to bat half health. Nice Manta, though. Ferev is going to be stunned up. Also, with the Silver Edge, he's going to lose a lot of that armor. Looks like Baby Knight with the Yule Scepter is going to get a lot more magic damage. They get the Fiend's Grip back over here. Firo did manage to pick up one. He got the kill on the Axe. Looks like Fada and Yapzur are going to have to run away. Adam does get caught once again. That team fight was very broken up. Firo managed to get the Ice Wall onto Ace. Down. I mean, they've seen the smoke and everything. Even if they don't pop it right here, they do know about the intention. Now, the TPs are going to come into the shrine. Oh, Ferev gets caught by the call. He's going to pull right back in with the Fiend's Grip. Yapzur thinks about trying to initiate to stop that Fiend's Grip, and then thinks better of it, knowing that he can't actually stop Ferev from dying there. Firo and Fada are going to try and quickly do Rosh on themselves as a two-man combo. But Noya is here, and this isn't going to work. Firo jumps out, maybe catches Noya. He managed to get off the silence onto Firo. Can Ryze and Baby Knight take advantage of that silence and that damage over time? Ferev's away. manage to get off the ghost walk. C9 can take the Roshan, though.
Can they? I don't know. They're loading up a lifesteal bomb.
Yapzor, nice combination. On to Ace, but now here comes the combo. Heads to Joe. Manages to call out. Baby Knight activates his ultimate. Lets it go. Yapzor gets away with the Shallow Grave. Nice save from Adam. And now tries to heal up Fada, but get ripped apart. Fada, with all the damage being stolen away from him by Ace, is probably going to go down. That extra armor is keeping him alive, as well as the armlet toggling. Plasma field is not enough, so looks like Adam's sacrificial play does manage to get a hit, and then maybe two hits after that. Baby Knight's going to be forced to use his BKB
down.
Here. They do have
second.
The call out, but nice initiation from Yapzor. Actually spots Heads to Joe on the back lines and goes for him first. Now, it does allow Baby Knight to get out, but at least they stopped that counterplay. If they'd gone on the SF, they would have been countercalled by the Axe, and that could have turned bad.
Short cooldown. He may use it now.
The stun goes out. Baby Knight with the Corrosive Haze. Manta's off that one. Fada, another Lincoln save away from the Static Link. The ultimate does go down. Frev going to be caught by the Fiend's Grip here. They try and save him. The Axe is not there to be able to stop that Shallow Grave, so it will actually keep Frev alive. Now Ace comes forward, tries to finish him off, but a blink away just ahead of the Plasma Field saves his life. That Corrosive Haze combined with the Desolator just tears Ace apart. The Meteor is going to slightly miss, but it's still good enough to be able to get the kill on to Ryze. The Bane is down, but Hesta Joe is back up.
Bear is, like you said, they take the tier 3, and now top lane going in
Noia.
Firo.
He needs to hit this kick. Oh, it does land on Firo, and they manage to get the dust out. Firo has been caught inside the trees. What an excellent play. Firo, you know he's going to do these sort of things. His Invoker, especially in the early game, and this could be a lane of racks. Maybe Bears feel more comfortable keeping the buyback on Firo and losing this lane of racks. Call comes out. Fada caught without his rage. Does have it coming up in a second here, but he's already the Static Link onto him. Ace is beginning to chase him down, getting all that extra damage, but they're going to try and pop him with magic. He does manage to get off the BKB, starts running himself away. He has the gem, so his escape is crucial for Cloud9 to keep this map control. Firo, trying to slow down some of these heroes, does jump onto Ryze. Looks like missed initiation on a Baby Knight. Fails to claim that kill. Yapzor, four snaps forward, can't get him. And that is not good enough, I would say, for Bears. They're going to turn the only objective they feel comfortable taking with the double damage on Fauna. They're going to grab this shrine. But after this, once Cloud9 are all what? Ooh, this TP from Ryze. This is a dangerous one. They do manage to get the call out, though. The Yapzor caught, not going to be able to counter-initiate whatsoever. BKB activated by Hesta Joe. Now Fada tries to get himself away from the Static Link that did get bounced back to Ace, but he pops a BKB. Fiend's Grip on the side. Looks like it did manage to catch one, but Frev does manage to get
damage
out. Fada keeps on moving forward, but Ace is just hitting like a truck at this point. Nice AoE deafening blast.
Yeah, that's why I do like Midas Lifestealer quite a bit. Oh, BKB activated just to dodge the tornado. Okay.
Want to make sure they get this Aegis and they don't get initiated on. Yapzor gets caught by Hesta Joe. Nice pick. So with the extra life and now a numbers advantage, Bears may be caught with their pants down. At least for now, and Bears can actually push forward through to mid lane. Perez trying to catch somebody right now. He does get the Scythe of Ice onto Noia with the Shivas. They manage to get another Shivas out from Firo with the control coming in. Noia actually dodges the Meteor Blast. Nice turnaround with a silence and stun. Ace is rapidly approaching this team fight, and Bears have to retreat here. A little bit of a cold snap stun. Firo is going to be the one caught by the Static Link here. Hesta Joe jumps forward, misses out on a call, it looks like, but the stun still come in. That Deafening Blast is huge, though. Firo bounces away, and it looks like he will manage to get out, but a Fiend's Grip onto Fada might have just spelled the end of Fada's life here. A Bloodthorn ensures it. 80 seconds down, Cloud9. They're on the cusp of being able to win this game now with the bots, too, in case the initiation does come out. Yapzor baits the end initiation. Might still be caught, though. Does have a tornado covering his tracks. Noia and Ace are going to be on top of him, manage to hit the stun, and Yapzor is going to die. He gets off a last man crush, but...
Ooh, drops a gem also. That's a bit expensive.
Swak and Blink Dagger doesn't seem to be enough to get a fast kill. And if they pursue this teep, then they may still end up running into a full five-man and Ryze. Now, Ryze is going to get blown up by that combination. Baby Knight, he Silver Edges on through, gets caught by the tornado. Ice Wall laid out as well, so he's going to have to head around. Stun kick out from Noia, but here comes that Scythe of Ice from earlier from Ferev. The Sunstrike over the top. Finish him off with a Timber Chain, a little bit more. They've got him. So, Bears do manage to find two picks. They are the supporting crew of Cloud9. That isn't a game.
It's still going to go on for a while. Roche is up now, so this is going to be an important objective if either team figures it out.
Bots 2, they're going to catch Hesta Joe. This is excellent. They take out the big initiator of Cloud9 while the two supports are still down, maybe.
Hestajo gets his TP canceled by Fearow with a cold snap as well.
Hestajo's probably going to die to Fearow now, but Ferret may have been caught around those melee racks. A stun comes out from Yabzor. Fada comes forward, but thinks better of it. Even with the Crows of Haze, he doesn't want to fight into that one. His Adam's already dead. They don't have that Shallow Grave. He throws out the Abyssal Blade while he's still raged up, so he doesn't take that Unstable Current slow, but he looks like he's still going to go down. Silence up by Noya. May just catch Yabzor as well. They finally bring Hestajo down so Fearow can join this fight and get out a Tornado, maybe to save Slardar's life. A long-range sleep. Yabzor trying to sprint himself away, but Ace, he's actually faster than Slardar. He's going to be able to catch him out with the Plasma Field. That will be the Aegis. And now for Evan Fearow, have to try and strike back, get the right kind of initiation. Good Shiva's initiation on Ace as well from Fearow, but Yabzor dies a second time, and now Ferev, very rapidly running out of mana, heads towards the trees, but they've got him with a Static Link, a Deafening Blast, trying to bribe. Ferev, Chakram's out. Managed to hit Hestajo there. Hestajo was planning on actually calling there. Does manage to jump Fearow now. Fearow's in serious trouble. Had a Meteor Blast going down, but just gets executed. He's going to have to buy back, and this is the beginning. Oh, they managed to get a bash onto Baby Knight as he was throwing out the Wrecking of the Souls. There is a buyback apiece now. Hestajo turns around, managed to get two on the call. Ferev still being comboed up by the Fiend's Grip. Rai stays alive because Hestajo's initiation. He managed to complete that Fiend's Grip. Another buyback out for the Timbersaw. The Refresher is used by Fearow. Tries to get max deafening blast charges onto C9 to bounce them back, but they can't actually get the kill. Hestajo sacrificing his life to make sure Bears can't pursue. Cloud9 running their way out. Looks like Ryze may be caught, but the cores get away. And that is what's most important here. Bloodthorn onto Ryze will ensure there is no counterplay from him. But Hestajo managing to get the call to keep the Fiend's Grip onto Ferev. All these heroes manage to get the crush, dodges the stun out from Noya, as well as the roll. This bot's two is actually coming in, but he's enchant remnanted. You don't want to be near Yapzor anymore. Yapzor is donezo. He does have a cheese, but he gets called up by Hestajo, and I don't think he would have popped it anyway. He just would have been beaten down again. See, though, jump outside the vice onto Baby Knight. Now here comes the buyback. Hestajo counters with a call, but Ace is actually being torn about by Fada right now. He managed to get Abyssal Blade, another bash, but now he's actually been Fiend Scripted up by Ryze, sitting on the side. Fada is going to end up going down. He does have buyback, so that is still okay. Managed to get the Infest off into Fearow. Well-timed Deafening Blast entrance, and he managed to get his hero out, but Baby Knight gets stunned up again. Fada pops out, tries to eliminate him, but still ends up going down. Now the buyback for Rev at half HP. Fearow sitting on the left-hand side, but if he gets
reading the
direction. Two onto Fearow, trying to jump in. Fred's going to be the first one forward. Doesn't manage to get a quick sight device onto anybody. Bots onto a creep as well. The Razor's going to be in this fight. Here comes the entrance. Hestajo gets pushed back by a Deafening Blast. BKB activated, so he managed to dodge all that Meteor Blast damage. Fada's got the Static Link on him. He's being torn apart by BB Knight and Ace. He does get the Shallow Grave. He's good for now. Hestajo's on the right-hand side. Refresher activated by Fearow. Turned around sight device. Hestajo does end up going down. Fada will lose his Aegis now, but Baby Knight's down to half health. Pops the Satanic. Starts beating on Fearow. Fearow now should get away. Ghost walk and he's out. Noya tries to catch up to him. Does manage to land that roll. Has the gem on Fearow as well. He activated that BKB. Does manage to get out back over to Fada, who's being kited around by these constant Scotties, but they do manage to get the dag on to Ryze. Fada pops his rage and TP's out. Yep. Fearow blinked forward, but right as he did, Hestajo managed to get into the trees and they didn't get a quick like Scythe of Ice blow up kill.
Yeah, see, that's the problem, is that all this initiation... Oh, never mind.
A quick blow-up kill. That is a quick blow-up kill. Holy crap. 2 minutes. Hestajo, he doesn't have buyback. He's already made his initiation. They're going to try and bots two in with the SF, but now they're at a numbers disadvantage. It's a 4v5 for Cloud9. They're going to try and chase down Ferev on the right-hand side here. They might be able to finish him up if Fiend's Grip goes down, but he's going to immediately buy back and TP into this engagement. Baby Knight with a BKB. Turns around, faces up against Fada, who managed to infest inside of Yabzor. Off Ryze, but Ferev leaves it out there. Looks like he was orchided up, so he couldn't. He doesn't get the pullback damage that would have finished off Ryze. They're going to try and execute Ace while Hestajo is still down for another 10 seconds. Hestajo, he's not here, and Ace dies. He's going to be forced into a buyback. A range racks goes down. Fada going to be slowed down by the Scotty. Ace keeps on coming forward. He has the Static Link ready to go, but he gets bumped back. Deafened Glass and a Bloodthorn usage. Ace, Fiend's Grip, Ryze in the background. There's nothing to be able to stop him. A Scythe of Ice comes out, but it's on to Ace. Now the follow-up. Fada goes down. Fearow, he ends up getting dropped as well. Buybacks are going to be forced to use by Bears if they can't fully retreat from this one. It looks like they caught Ferev as well. Yabzor, he may be caught here by Hestajo, leaps onto the maybe giving up into Megas to be able to hold until Ferev is back up. Now the initiation, BKB activated. Fada, he actually gets on it. Hestajo here, Deafening Blast aren't effective with the BKB still activated, but he manages to stop the Requiem of Souls, and Baby Knight's down. 2 minutes, no buyback. Fada, he goes for ace up next, managed to get a lucky bash. Now Yopsor comes in, the BKB lasts a little bit long, but not long enough to stop this tornado with the Sunstrike. Ace is down as well. 2 minutes, and this could be the end. Bears, they've killed two cores with no buyback. Ryze does have a buyback, but they're missing all of their damage. They just seem to be too tanky. The tier fours are going to go down. Cloud9 finally come forth. BKB activated by Hestijo. Pops that Blade Mail, but you see Fero is only going to go down to maybe half health. They get comboed up by Slardar. Hits with a double crush, and that will be it. Cloud9, they brought Bears into their world, the late game world that they're so experienced with, but Bears still... But he is against a Lifestealer and Coddle. That isn't going to be the most treacherous of lanes. In fact, with Noya, they are going to try and take this bounty rune. The TK goes out. They already get a big blast, though. And Noya's dropping lower and lower. He can't really commit to the bounty rune. Fada is still going to be able to pick it up. And it looks like Noya just gave up first blood as well as the bounty.
He has a DK. Will he use it?
Yapsor has a roll in 2 seconds. The creeps aren't going to spawn for another 15. He needs to dodge this roll. Can't do it. Yapsor nails him. First blood goes to him.
Okay, well, I guess that means that Rubick needs to...
They don't have a Meld Strike, but the right click comes out from Ryze, a Fairy Fire, and now a Healing Salve from Fero will bump him back up to full HP. Adam may be caught, though. Hester Joe's going to be able to... He came out with that Waning Rift. Well played. The offlane Puck finding the first kill. And the kick does stall up the damage on Fero, but he is being constantly threatened. Oh, 8 HP is all that's left. He heads back to the shrine and will receive almost a full heal off of that one. Actually does this early on into the game, but they are really taking it to Fero. And I think they did try and put a lot of pressure on him last time as well on the Invoker. He does seem to be one of the big keys of success for Bears. Has Joe. Nice dodge on that one. Will manage to get the... Nice silence. Yapsor managed to catch Hester Joe. Hester Joe will now die. A big pickup as Fada now will pick up his level 5 against that level 5 Puck. Adam not actually blocked in by Noya there. I thought he was going to be, but they may still be able to run him down with the extra movement speed of Ace. He does close that gap and gets the auto attack required. 2-2 now.
See, I did want to.
Very low HP and no shrine to heal him back up.
That silence that Yapsor used on Puck is going to be a problem all game long. And so it's kind of, it's a weird situation as a Puck because you put out the Illusory Orb, you want to go as far as possible. But at the same time, the Earth Spirit knows you want to go as far as possible and is going to hold on to that silence until you're like, okay, it's about 1,000 units away. I'm going to jaunt to it now. Oh, wait, I can't. So I don't really know how you itemize this Puck this game. Like, do you go for the Yules just to take that off, or you want to go aggressive, go for the Blink Dagger? And given his start, kill onto Yapsor, Eclipse used.
Nice pickup. Tombstone will be left out there. It's the kind of aggressive plays that they want to be able to find the kills and then turn that into a tier 1 tower. It's not going to be possible, though, with Adam sitting so far back. He's sitting on the far right-hand side and always is blasting away. So that early advantage that is usually found by Luna is being countered by the Coddle currently. Hestijo did have to jump to his orb pretty far out there. Yapsor is going to be able to get ahead of him, manage to land the kick, silence, and Yapsor claims another kill. The Earth Spirit, it seems, is going to be just as effective in the early game as Noya. With these kind of... we wanted to see a tankier mid, right? A lane-dominating mid, kind of like Viper, to give Cloud9 a bit of sustain. Cloud9 are very squishy because of their choice of the Templar Assassin. If the right kind of initiation comes through from Bears, they blow up this whole entire lineup. So I do like the fact that they're not trying to be overly aggressive like we've seen from C9 before. And when it comes to taking objectives, I think you need to focus on making sure you have your early game farm first. That way you have a very big impact around 15 minutes. An attempt at a smoke from Hestijo and Ryze gets spotted, though, by Ferev. Bottom lane, Noya's going to be caught here as he tried to lane out, gets blasted down. Bears make their first aggressive infest maneuver.
Yeah, I like how Ferev... So what is... So Fero has a Glove of Haste. Is he going to go for Midas, or is that just for treads? Like, what is the item progression for a Shadow Fiend this game? Nice initiation bot.
He is going to be feeling the big-time nukes. The Illuminate Blast does land. Multiple TPs are coming in. They'll finish off Ace, yes, but now they're going to be caught by the Dream Coil of Hester Joe. Fada turns, attempts to fight, does not have the Rage to be able to jump out of this coil, but he's having to deal with the Tombstone Zombies the whole entire time. Rage coming back up in 1 second time. Can he just Rage TP away? Looks like he will be good. They try and get some...
...is where I'm most interested in, because he's there to either stop fights or start fights. And last in a bot push, oh nice, roll in.
Nice silence from Yapzor preemptively as he rolls in, manages to stop Hestijoel from phase shifting. And Fada easily cleans up the kill.
Well, he did start that fight, so I'm still right. It just wasn't the fight that he wanted.
This is going to be really fast Desolated with the way they're successfully hitting these ganks. They're going to pop back in with the infest. Doesn't quite land the boulder, but it will be okay with the stun. They'll still manage to get that killed, but Fada's in pretty deep.
He has Rage TP.
Rage TP out. Nothing to stop there. Yapzor is looking for a rollout himself or a TP. Rice gets the telekinesis, and they will get that kill. Support for support, but it's space for Firo.
Yapzor is burning through these rocks. He would have been liked to be able to get out of that. Nice double edge on to Hestia, but the first raise misses.
Firo's just going to straight TP out. Rise won't be there in time to be able to stop it. Telekinesis still on cooldown anyway, but they are running Cloud9 around the map. You could see.
Surprised they're not pushing more aggressively for this. Maybe if they get a pick first. Off.
The refraction is going to wear out here with the silence now on Baby Knight. Can't meld, can't refract again. They try and finish him off the stampede, but now the turnaround. Baby Knight, he's dropped low enough that Firo can finish him off with the raises. The Eclipse would not deal enough damage. Looks like it was too split. Vareb managed to tank most of it. Nice kick from Yapzor. A follow-up silence. Hestijoel's trying to stay ahead of Fada. Face shift for a second, but can't get the orb out. Now Ryze is going to be caught. Yapzor rolls in, managed to catch him. And this is why the Yapzor Earth Spirit is so feared. Almost every single one of these deaths on the side of Cloud9 has been because of...
1800 night vision just right off the bat. Right now, it's just sitting with bonus 250 instead of bonus 1000, so didn't see and didn't
nice
see this.
Double stomp with a double kick coming in as well. Doesn't look like it hit Baby Knight, so he's able to blink backwards, but Ace is already gone, as well as the Tombstone. A Dream Call comes out. He may have to jump backwards into the back lines of Bears here and probably still get caught out as he doesn't have a blink to be able to get away. Baby Knight trying to punish Fada there, but it looks like the tier 1 tower, the first one at mid, will be
isn't going to be a thing.
Ryze being a good guy, trying to open up farm for the puck with a Fade Bolt. Will be Noya caught, but it looks like Ace is going to get away, unless with the Blink Dagger of Firo. No. They don't have anything to catch Ace. The Shrine or the mid-tier 2, and they try and get aggressive on Bears while Fada's at top lane. They need to try and take advantage of this time to get the Blink, as well as Bears being a little bit split up, but it looks like Ryze is going to be the one caught here. Stampede going to run him over. Baby Knight watches as his support dies. They're going to get the Dream Coil out onto just one there. They do have the Eclipse, but Ferev's able to take it really well with the Hood of Defiance. Now all the damage, it's gone. Firo's lined up for the ultimate with a sick combination from Yapzor, setting up all that with his stun. Bears trample quite literally with the Stampede over Cloud9. They're pulling out a really good compliment to Noya and his Earth Spirit. And honestly, it was a very respectable Earth Spirit player. He had a huge impact on landing phase, but I'm not sure.
This good?
Yeah, I'm not sure if it's this good. Yapzor is going to be able to get a double kill. Silence. Cloud9 try and jump forward here, seeing Bears a little bit low on HP and SF at the top lane, but they just can't do it. Not without Eclipse. Now the bounce back. Ace is running out of mana. The mana leak wears out, but now he's hit by the stomp. Hestijoel tries to stop all this with a jump in silence Dream Coil, but it's still not enough. The Illuminate Blast finishes him off. Baby Knight in the back lines does finally get a kill for Cloud9. It's going to be the Centaur, but now he's left in no man's land against the SF and the Earth Spirit. 6-21. They trade 1-3, and Bears pushing high ground by 20. Shrine. Honestly, Cloud9, they need some miraculous five-man smokes and some pickoffs.
More pickoffs, yes, but TA only finds a Centaur with this shiny new Desolator. Meanwhile, Fada gets a kill on a Rubick.
Gonna need the Dream Coil to slow down Ferev. He turns around, threatens something, but he doesn't actually have Hoof Stomp, so he will end up dying here. That's a big pick. That kill is worth 500. No. That's the Lifestealer one.
Daytime. The glorious day where Kahl can run free. They don't have... Oh, never mind. They have a gem. Centaur bought it for Adam. And now all of the energy that he spent... Oh, bye-bye, Illusion. That's okay. They can afford to do that. They can afford to do that like 10 times over and still win this game.
They certainly can. They've taken the other shrine. Ags is also being built on Yapzor. Apparently Yapzor really wants to show Noya how you use it.
Yeah, I would like to see it. Hopefully they can complete it before the game ends, as now there's a Blink Dagger with most people would expect the Centaur to be the vehicle, but no, it's going to be
nice Blink Silence. Hestijoel's caught. He goes down. Frev does receive the telekinesis. He tries to go in. Ace just moves forward with the Eclipse. They've already taken out the Coddle. He's trying to get these bounces on Yapzor. Does manage to block his roll out, get the physical damage to finish him off, but Fada will clean up that other kill. They do turn this fight pretty decently. They've killed Frev. Now Baby Knight, he does have the refraction charges now that the damage over time is gone, but SF is here. He has to blink out. Nice timing there from Baby Knight. Looks like they'll get away. Trade free, 3 for 3. And they lost two of their cores, but I still think that's to the advantage of Cloud9, considering the gigantic lead by Bears.
Oh, hell yeah. Anything that they can get is an advantage. I can't believe that they were able to even get those three to begin with. Granted, SF wasn't there, and Life Cycle and Eclipse will probably lose all of its efficacy between Pipe and that Ag, but I mean, they don't need to wait for it. The tier 3 is down.
They do see Ace in the side. They're going to be able to get the Hoof Stomp, an Orchid as well. They take him down. Rise down to half health after just one shot from Firo. Here comes that second shot. A third one is needed. Rise. Oh, the Shrine. Not going to be good enough to save him. Firo 1v2 in the back lines. It looks like Baby Knight's trying to get things done, but there's too many heroes back there. He ends up dying. No buyback there. Cloud9, beyond godlike triple kill for Firo. I have to say, Cloud9, like, that the game won. It was awesome. And
damn good game.
Yeah.